This is our model of the alveolar sac. Starting from the outside, this layer is the pleura, specifically the visceral pleura. And then you can see there are layers in here. We've got the connective pleura attached to these structures here. Each of these little bunches that look like a bunch of grapes, this is an alveolar sac. And each of the little round things, like a grape, is an alveolus. So together, many alveoli make up each alveolar sac. And many alveolar sacs make up a lobule, which is what we have here. Now up here, you can see the bronchi that have branched into very tiny little tubes, kept open not by rings of cartilage anymore, but by little plates of cartilage. And those branch into smaller tubes that are wrapped not in cartilage, but in smooth muscle. And those are the bronchioles. So bronchi have cartilage, bronchioles do not have cartilage. The terminal bronchioles are the largest of the bronchioles, and then they are going to branch into even smaller tubes like this one here, which is a respiratory bronchiole. And that's going to feed into the alveolar sac. Going through the alveolar sac is an alveolar duct, which is a tube. It's going to be like a branch connecting all of our grapes or alveoli in this little alveolar sac. And each of the alveoli has a wall that's one cell thick. That's what you see here. That helps gas exchange, helps the oxygen and carbon dioxide move across the walls of these very efficiently. There are also pores between the alveoli so that as air rushes in and out, it can very quickly and efficiently flow throughout the alveolar sac. Now, the other thing we see are the blood vessels. Now, remember, the blood coming in is deoxygenated, coming from the right ventricle. So this is deoxygenated blood in a branch of the pulmonary artery, and that branches into an arteriole that branches into a capillary bed. And each of these little alveoli is going to be wrapped in its own capillary bed. The blood's going to flow around the alveolus through this capillary bed, become oxygenated, and then flow out through these pulmonary venules that combine to form pulmonary veins, and those pulmonary veins will flow back to the left side of the heart.